Conveniently timed exposition captures Shinsu thinking out loud how she's powerless without an Empress. For those of you who don't know, the previous Empress was brutally murdered. Shinsu, wondering if there's no one left in the Empress bloodline to wield her power, is how you know there is someone left. Otherwise, there wouldn't be a story, let alone this video. Episode 2, Empress in Training. Committee of Arev citizens gather to discuss what to do now that they're Empressless. Committee also mentions the Black Mage becoming stronger and stronger despite being sealed. Probably should have used a better seal. Or duct tape. That's how you know a badass has entered the scene. Forget introducing yourself. Just shout the solution to everyone's problem. Not only did Nineheart know that there still existed a person of the Empress's bloodline, but he found and brought her conveniently to the meeting discussing the very issue. Talk about the deus ex machina of deus ex machinas. Either that, or Kimu just mentioned a moment ago that Shinsu said she was the descendant of the Empress. Enter Yu in the story, who's brought in by Nineheart to help mentor the young soon-to-be Empress. You don't seem to have much of a choice, as it's either jump off a cliff or say no to a sickly, desperate little girl. After accepting to help teach the Empress, your first task is to get a book. Because books make people smart. And which book are you off to get? Weren't you paying attention? It's that book. The one convenient for the plot. Origin story for Nineheart's monocle. After working on making Cygnus smarter, you're tasked with making her look nicer. For a normal person, you can typically get by with either looking good or being smart. However, this is the Empress standards we're talking about. By the way, if you're looking for ideas on how to compliment a person on their looks, you came to the right place. This and this are clear indicators that you've got a genuine experience. After a couple months, Cygnus falls ill and you're tasked with obtaining a cure. Nosy potion maker wants to know who the cure's for. Lucky for him, you're a terrible liar. Lucky for you, he settles for an answer that contradicts his nosiness. Upon returning with the medicine, Cygnus isn't too sure she wants to become an empress. After all, that's a lot of responsibility for such small shoulders. This, of course, gives Nineheart the perfect opportunity to share his motivational story to push the plot. Long backstory short, Nineheart decided waiting for Aran to awaken was a waste of time, so he set out on a quest to find the next empress to save the world. The lesson being delivered to Cygnus is that she's free to choose her own path and shouldn't be pressured into becoming the empress. This leaves me curious as to what Nineheart would have done if she really took his advice and didn't become the empress. Or perhaps he's a sick and twisted guy playing mind games with a sick child. You can leave, but you know that if you do, the world will suffer, so deal with it, is what he's really saying. Meanwhile, a villain named Orchid hears rumors of medicine being delivered to Arev. Must be a new heir to the Empress. Who else could it be? Let's also take this moment to recognize the real villain in this scenario. Nosy Potion Maker is also Big Mouth Potion Maker. This ultimately leads to the evil organization called the Black Winds to launch an attack on Arev, which also becomes a perfect opportunity for Cygnus to demonstrate her leadership skills. After making a pact with Shinsu, the new Empress is born and you help fight off the Black Winds. You would think that you'd stick around to ensure the safety of the Empress and her future, but you've got better things to do. It would probably be reasonable for Cygnus to band together a group of knights to protect her, since she's now a prime target. I wonder what she'd call the... Really?